Hello everyone, Miss Carrie here from Miss Carrie's Creations. Today I'm going to show you how I used elements from another card workshop kit to create a Christmas card. Let's go ahead and get started with the project. Today I'm going to be creating a Christmas card using one of the dies in the Wander card making workshop. Now, this workshop has all of the items that you need to create four of each of the cards that you see there. The minute I saw this card making workshop, I knew that I wanted to make a Christmas card. That little city scene looked just like the town of Bethlehem, so I decided to snag it to be able to make myself a Christmas card. The only item I used to make my Christmas card that was in the Wander kit was this cityscape die. I'll use all of the other items in the kit later on to make these cards that are shown, but the only way I could get a hold of the cityscape die was by purchasing the Wander card making kit. And it's only available for a few more days, so I needed to get a hold of it so that I could make more of these Christmas cards later on. Now the other item that I use today is called the Reason for the Season stamp set. I have already used this stamp set to stamp some images on White Daisy cardstock. I'm going to be shading these images with alcohol markers, so I needed the ink to set before I start coloring the images. I've also stamped the images onto two pieces of White Pines pattern paper. I'm going to be paper piecing Mary and Joseph's clothing using the tree patterned paper for Joseph's coat and the glacier diamond paper for Mary's cloak. These White Pines patterned papers are beautiful. If you don't have some, you can use any patterned paper in your collection. If you would like to get a hold of the White Pines paper, just remember that it's only available for a limited time because it's part of our Bring Back My Pack special. The first thing I want to do is create the night sky behind the silhouette. I'm going to be using some Distress Oxide inks in Black Soot, Chipped Sapphire, and Pumice Stone to create that night scene. I'm going to start by adding some chipped sapphire ink to my White Daisy cardstock in the upper right corner. That is the only spot where I need the ink to be, so I don't need to cover that entire piece of cardstock with ink. Now, if you don't know much about Distress Oxides, let me explain them just a little bit to you. They are a hybrid ink, so you have a dye ink and a pigment ink blended into one. The dye allows this ink to dry quickly, and the pigment gives you the ability to blend these inks so beautifully. All right, once I've added the chipped sapphire, I'm just going to come in with the black soot, and I'm just going to create a halo around the chipped sapphire ink. I'm going to blend the two together and create a nice night scene. Now I'm going to come back in once again with my chipped sapphire, and I'm going to blend it just a little bit more with that black soot. After I've blended those two inks together, then I'm going to bring in my pumice stone ink. Now the pumice stone is a pale gray ink, but it's going to create that little bit of light that's going to shine behind my white star. So I don't need a whole lot of the pumice stone, just a little bit in the center of that chipped sapphire, and then we are all done. I'm going to go ahead and set this aside and let it dry so that I can add some heat embossing to it later. I'm going to be shading Mary and Joseph with tri-blends. The cloaks are going to be covered with patterned paper, but I want the tunics to be shaded with my tri-blend. So I'm going to be using a couple of different blends here to create the tunic on Joseph. I'm going to be using the earth brown shades, the earth brown blend, and the gold brown shades. I've gone ahead and zoomed into my project so that it's much easier for you to see me shade these two images with the tri-blends. I'm going to start by shading his tunic with the lightest gold brown shade. When I'm using these tri-blend alcohol markers, I like to go from light to dark. I can always add more dark shadows as I go, but I really can't take them away. Some people like to start with the dark shadow colors first and then add the light. For me, it's much easier to go from light to dark. After adding that lighter color of the gold brown, I'm going to come in with my darkest color and start my first layer of shading. Right now, I'm just putting the pigment into the folds of the clothing and along the edges of the tunic where his cloak is going to be overlapping and causing a shadow. I'm going to blend the two colors together with that medium tone marker. Now, this is the benefit of having a tri-blend, three colors in one. There's no searching for the light, mid, or dark colors. Everything's right there at your fingertips. To deepen those shadows even more, I'm going to come in with some of my earth brown blends. I'm going to add some deeper tones around the edges of the tunic, in the folds of the sleeve, and underneath his beard. After using a few different shades from the earth brown blend, I decided to add some of the earth brown shade colors. That's an even deeper brown color, and that gives me a nice shadow layer along the edges of the tunic, in the folds of all of the sleeves, down there at the base around where the baby's going to be, because that's going to create a dark shadow, and underneath his beard. Now at this point, all of the lines look a little bit rough, and that's when you come in with your original color that you used and you start blending all of those shadow and light layers together. So I've brought in my gold brown shades, and I'm using the light and the medium and the dark to blend all of those shadow layers. I'm going to start with the darker tones, and then I'm going to finish off with the lightest tone, and this is just going to create a nice light and shadow effect on Joseph's tunic. Mary's clothing is shaded in the same manner as Joseph's tunic. I use the ice gray blend and the ice gray shades for her clothing. So I've just gone around with the lighter tones, and then I came in with the darker shades to add the bits of shadow under her face and in all of the folds of her clothing and around her cloak. And then I just finished it off with the lighter tones to blend it all together. Now, if you'd like to see me shade these images in real time, you can go ahead and head on over to my private Facebook group. I did a live video showing some tips and tricks for using tri-blends as I shaded these two images. The faces of all three figures are shaded with Fair Skin Blend. The biggest thing to remember when you're shading the faces is to think of the light that's going to be coming down from the star so that you can create a shadow effect on one side of the face. So if you take a look at this little close-up of baby Jesus's face, you can see that I created more shadow towards the base of his face, and then I created a highlight at the top of his face because we're going to have that light coming down across his face, and so we're creating this transition from light to shadow. I've gone ahead and shaded Mary's hair with the muted brown blend, and now I'm adding color to the hay using the gold brown blend. So once again, just starting out with that lightest color, bringing in the darker color for shadows, and then blending it all together with the medium and the light tone of that gold brown blend marker. If you're not a fan of coloring with alcohol markers, you could also shade these images with colored pencils or with watercolors. Either one of those would look absolutely beautiful. I wanted to add a little bit of shadow around the baby's swaddling clothing, so I used a light ice gray, and the lines were a little bit harsh after adding that shadow layer. So I went and grabbed my blending marker, which causes the ink to bleed just a little bit and fade. And this will soften some of those harsh lines that your markers create when you're trying to create a soft shadow. Now that these images have been shaded, I'm going to go ahead and cut out the little cloak portions from my patterned paper so I can start creating my paper piecing pieces. Say that five times. All right, since these pieces are technically the outer layers on these images, I'm going to be cutting on the outside of the black line. If I were creating the tunics or even the faces, I would probably cut on the inside of the black lines. But like I said, since these are the outer pieces on the images, I'm going to be cutting on the outside of the black line so that that black line frames these paper piecing pieces. When I was creating Mary's cloak, I noticed that there was a little sliver right there along the left side. When I looked at other projects created with this stamped image, most people left that white, but I realized that it looked a little out of place. So I'm creating a secondary layer out of patterned paper instead. The next step is to glue these pieces down just like a puzzle. It almost reminds me of quilt applique. And actually, that's kind of where I was inspired to create this project. I saw a quilt applique recently that was of a nativity, and their clothing was created out of different patterns of cotton cloth. And I thought, you know what? I can do that with paper. And that's exactly what I did. I used those soft patterns in that White Pines paper pack to create kind of an applique out of my stamped image. Now, a pair of tweezers does come in handy when you are paper piecing because some of those smaller pieces are a little bit difficult to pick up, and those tweezers are going to help you with placement. On each of those patterned pieces, I did add a little bit of shading using the tri-blends. I used the light muted brown blend on Joseph's cloak and the light ice gray blend on Mary's. Adding the shadows with your markers isn't necessary, but it does give it a cohesive look. Now, if you feel like the lines are a little bit too harsh, you can go ahead and come in with that blending marker one more time and just soften up some of those lines along that patterned paper. The last step is to add another layer of color using some white gel pens. I'm just going to go ahead and fill in some of the decorations on both of their cloaks using one of the white gel pens. I love adding details with white gel pens to my stamped images and die cuts, and I'm excited to announce that we're going to have these available starting September 1st on my website. I love adding detail to images, and white gel pens allows me to do that. Someone told me that watching my videos was almost like watching an infomercial. She said, you get to the point where you think she's almost done, and she goes, but wait, there's more. And that's kind of what the white gel pens do. They just add that finishing touch to any project. Off camera, I've gone ahead and cut out those two images. I've grabbed a piece of espresso cardstock and a piece of crafts cardstock. And now I'm going to use that Wander die cut shape to cut out that Bethlehem silhouette. In this workshop bundle, you are getting a stamp set and some dies to create those cards. Your dies include two silhouette stamps, one for a mountain scene and one for the cityscape. And I'm going to be using the cityscape because it reminds me of the town of Bethlehem. I'm going to go ahead and use some post-it tape to place this down in the upper right-hand corner of my craft cardstock. And then I'm just going to go off camera and use my die cutting machine to cut this out. At the base of the craft cardstock, I'm going to add the sentiment. This comes from that Reason for the Season stamp set. And I'm just going to stamp the sentiment using black ink right along the bottom. To extend the sentiment across the base of the card and create almost a grounding line for that stamped image, I've grabbed a black journaling pen and I'm creating two short lines on either side of the sentiment. And then I'm just going to hand draw some little leaves along those lines to match the leaves that are on Mary's cloak. This creates a base for that stamped image to set upon so it doesn't look like it's floating on the card. Before I adhere all of the pieces together, I'm just going to add a little bit of toffee ink around the edges of this craft cardstock. I'm only applying toffee ink to the left side of the buildings because I want it to look like the light from the star is reflecting over on the right side. Speaking of stars, I still need to add that star image onto that distress oxide background. So I'm just going to prep my surface with an anti-static pouch. And then I'm going to place that craft layer down to help me with the placement of the star image. I'm going to be using white embossing powder, so I will be using white pigment ink to stamp my image. Now you are welcome to use Versamark ink if you would like. I just like using the white pigment ink because it gives me a crisper image when I'm using white embossing powder. After stamping that image, I'm going to sprinkle it with the white embossing powder. Tap off the excess powder, and then I'm going to heat the image with a heat tool. And once it's nice and shiny, I know that those plastic crystals have melted. Before I attach the craft paper, I do want to add a little bit of shimmer around that star. So I've grabbed a clear shimmer brush, and I'm just going to tap it and splatter it onto that background. Once I was finished with the night sky, then I could place that craft layer on top and create that Bethlehem scene. I did add some foam tape in between the two layers to give me a shadow effect. Let's take a look at this up close so that you can see that shimmer effect around the large star. Isn't that cool? This craft layer is going to be adhered down onto a piece of espresso cardstock, and then that will be adhered down onto a standard size card base. Once the background of the card was complete, all I need to do was add that stamped nativity scene that we created. So I'm just going to use some thin foam tape on the back of the two images and place it right on the front of the card, making it look like Mary and Joseph are sitting right there in front of the town of Bethlehem. And now our Bethlehem nativity card is complete. I love taking items in my collection and using them in a new way. On this card, we use that city scene that came with the Wander card making workshop, and I was able to create the town of Bethlehem. This was something that I saw right away when I bought this kit, and I just couldn't wait to make it for you. I want to thank you for joining me today for another card making tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed learning how to make this card, and I hope that it helps you look at some of the items in your stash in a whole new way. If you would like to see any of my other card making tutorials, you can go ahead and click on that playlist above. While you're at it, please hit the subscribe button so that you are notified when I add another video to my channel. I hope that you have a wonderful week, and I can't wait to see what you create.